Hey guys, so as you're watching this on a video right now, I probably don't have to tell you just how awesome video content actually is. But just how powerful is it as a marketing tool? Well, 45% of people watch an hour or more of YouTube or Facebook videos per week. More than 500 million hours are watched on YouTube every single day. And more than 500 million people are watching videos on Facebook every single day. I could go on and on, but the point is, video is definitely the way of the future. The problem is, not everyone is super comfortable jumping on a live stream, for example, when there could be all sorts of tech glitches or wardrobe malfunctions for their entire audience to witness while it's actually happening. So for those of you who want to get creative with video in a less intimidating way, then today's tutorial is definitely for you. We'll be taking a look at how you can leverage Adobe Spark's video function in order to amaze and engage with your audience. So if you're ready, let's do it. So we're going to get started by heading to spark.adobe.com. Now I'm going to begin by showing you the premium version of this tool for those of you who, like myself, already have a Creative Cloud membership with Adobe. And then at the end, I'll also show you what the free version looks like and an easy way that you can get around paying the monthly Spark fee. So I'm going to go ahead and log in here. Now once you log into your premium membership account, you'll see a tab up top that says Manage Your Brand. You'll also see this one on the free accounts, but it won't take effect unless you actually upgrade. So this is where you'll be able to add your logos, fonts, and your brand colors, which will make it super easy for you to make beautiful branded videos that are customized to you and your business. So this will be blank, and then we've just gone in and added our font and our colors over here as well. So once you've added in all of your branded elements, you can then begin by clicking this plus sign up top and creating a new post, page, or video. So you can also use Spark to create posts for social media or even page layouts for your website, but for the purposes of this tutorial, we're going to be sticking to their video function, as I find that this is where people get a little bit stuck when it comes to getting really creative with their visual content. So let's go ahead and create a video. This is where it's going to ask you to tell a bit of a story. So all this means is that you need to give your video a title, and this can always be changed later and will really only impact the file name once you download your project. So we're just going to go ahead and name this test video one and click on next. So this is where you need to pick what your video will actually be about. Are you promoting an idea? Are you telling your viewers what's happened? Or are you telling the story of your company? This will then preload a template which will prompt you with clues about what to put in each part of your video. So for my purpose here, I will be selecting the show and tell category over here. So one thing you'll notice as soon as we jump in here is that this tool is extremely simple and its customizability is quite limited. This can be really handy though for anyone who's quite frustrated by the complex tools out there and just wants to simplify their video creation process. So you can already tell that we've got a few prompts down here. So it's going to prompt you to tell your viewers a little bit about you, what it is, why it is, show the product, how it's come to be. And this is where certain things will pop up as well to let you know what you can do to improve your video. So the first thing we're going to do is choose a theme up top here. And I have my branded themes over here, and then followed by the generic ones over here, which you will see on the free version as well. So we're going to go with this dark branded one over here. You can then head over to music and select from their free tracks here, unless you have your own audio file that you can also upload, if perhaps you've pre-purchased your audio file there. But otherwise, I'm just going to select this one, and here's where you can go and increase or decrease the audio volume as well. Then we can move on to designing the slides themselves, and we'll be doing this in the layout tab over here. So you'll notice that as you go along, you'll get these prompts, and also it's going to allow you to record your voice over each slide if you wish. The elements that you can actually place on each slide, if you click on this plus sign, are video, text, photos, or icons. So you will find some free icons and images inside Spark as well by using the search function over here. But if you wish to use video clips, you will have to upload your own. You can also increase or decrease the length of each slide using the slider over here. So if you click on the 2 seconds, you can increase that or decrease it depending on how long you want the video clip or the photograph or the text to show for. So I'm going to begin by selecting the split screen function over here and inserting a video of me for my first slide. So I'm going to go ahead and do that on this side over here and select the video. Now you can see that my video clips are all in 1 minute long video file here. So I can just go and select the portion that I want to use in my slide by using this little trimmer over here. So I want to make sure I don't go over until the next clip here. So I just want to take the first 5 seconds and hit save. So it's now accidentally actually placed it on the left side of my split screen. So I want to use these arrows to move it over to my right side here. And then I can use the button up the top right hand corner of the video in order to zoom in on certain parts of the clip. If I only want to use maybe a portion of it, or I can zoom back out. I can also trim the clip, or I can lengthen it, and then I can adjust the volume of the clip, or I can mute it altogether if it doesn't really belong in this project. While you're in the editing function and you hover over the video, you'll see a little hand pop up. If you click through, it'll allow you to adjust the portion of the clip that's actually showing, since this is a wide video clip, but we're only showing a portion of it. So you want to just click and make sure you're centering the part of the clip that you want to be showing. And you can always play it just to make sure that the part that you want to show is actually showing here. So that looks good to me, and I want to put some text over on my left-hand side here. So I'm just going to go ahead and type the word freedom and dot, dot, dot. Cool, that looks like a good first slide to me. I'm going to go ahead onto my second slide. I'm going to split screen again, but this time we're going to be putting our video clip on the other side. So I'm going to use this same longer video clip and just adjusting it to the portion that I want. So once again, while I'm in the editing function over here, I can move my clip around to make sure that only the part that I actually want to be displaying is displaying. I can zoom in and out a little bit if I want to show a bit more of the clip. So let's go ahead and click play to see if you can see me and the turtle. Yeah, that looks cool. And I'm going to go ahead and add some text over here. Dot, dot, dot. And for my third slide, I'm going to go ahead and add a photo this time around. So I'm going to go ahead and select a photo from my desktop, but I could go and find some free photos over here, but I've already got the photo that I want. So it's going to be this one over here. Cool, that looks good. And I'm going to go ahead and add my text. And this one is going to say travel. And you will also notice that it's actually darkened the photos, so it makes the text stand out a little bit more. Now, depending on how much text you actually use, you may want to lengthen the duration of the time that the photo displays for down here. So maybe I'd go for more like 4 seconds. I also want to make sure that the word is not actually covering my face. So you can drag these text boxes around by just clicking and holding. Maybe I would put it over here. And it's going to create our animations customized like that there. And it's going to zoom in on the photo a little bit as well and make the text disappear. So now I'm going to speed things up here just to complete my slides using the exact same steps that we've just used. So I might end up putting a bit more information about this in the caption associated with a video like this one if I was using it for a Facebook ad, for example. I might put something about how we travel the world full time while doing digital marketing for our clients. And at the end, also, you have the option with these slides to just click and delete these. If you don't think you need them, you don't have to have all of the ones that they recommend. And then you also have two slides for credits and your outro, so you can't remove this on the free accounts, but you can get rid of this or hide it on the paid or premium membership accounts. So you can then click on either preview or download in order to view your clip. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and we can view our video. So I'd be pretty happy with that for just a few minutes of work, but let me also show you what the difference is with the free plan by logging in as a free user over here. So once you're logged in, you won't actually have the option to create branded videos. If you were to go ahead and add brand over here, it will prompt you to upgrade in order to be able to save your logos and your fonts over here. So you can't actually have branded videos unless you are on the upgraded version. Let's go ahead and try and create a video so I can show you what the difference is there as well. So while in the video function, you won't have the option to create your own branded videos with your logo over here or your color scheme and fonts. And you will also have this Adobe Spark watermark in the bottom right hand corner instead. And you won't have the option to remove these final slides over here, and it will have another watermark in the final slide over there. So this is less than ideal, and unfortunately at the time of recording they're charging $9.99 a month for the upgraded version, and in my opinion it's really not a tool that's worth this kind of cost. You're actually better off paying $9.99 a month for Adobe's photography plan over here, which is the exact same cost and gives you Photoshop and Lightroom, and with it you also get access to Spark for free as a Creative Cloud member. So as a freelancer, I have found Spark to be a great tool for my clients who are maybe not so tech savvy but want to have a crack at creating their own videos. And for those of you who already have a Creative Cloud membership and you want to make quick, beautiful videos, then definitely give Spark a try. So I hope you guys really enjoyed that mini tutorial. And if you'd like to learn more about how you can take your social media presence to the next level, definitely check out the link in the description of this video for your access to our design school. And if you like this video, remember to like it, subscribe to our channel, and let me know what you'd like to see more of inside the comments. I'm always looking for more inspiration for future tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, keep creating the life you love.